Hello friends, welcome to a new lecture today. If you see in this lecture, I'm going to explain one more x-ray in surgery. So in this x-ray, if you see, this is the diaphragm. See, I'll just draw this here. This is the diaphragm. This is one more diaphragm. And here you have liver like this. You can see the even upper border of liver is seen, and there is a space here. Here there is air under the diaphragm. So this is the x-ray showing air under the diaphragm, and it is called as pneumoperitoneum. So here if you see, there is air under the diaphragm. So it is a plain x-ray showing collection of free air under the right dome of diaphragm. So what are the questions that they can ask in this lecture, in this topic? In this topic, they can ask us about the number one. So I'll just show you the questions. Okay, so they can ask you about the first, causes of air under the diaphragm. So they can ask us about the causes of air under the diaphragm. So for the causes of air under the diaphragm, first, it can be due to perforation of a hollow viscus. Any perforation, it can be due to duodenal ulcer, perforation of gastric ulcer, perforation of Merkel's diverticulum or malignant ulcers. It can be due to any perforation of the hollow viscus. It can be due to stab injury in the abdomen, or sometimes it can be due to laparotomy, or it can be due to tubal insufflation test. The test which you do, which is called as tubal insufflation test for tubal pregnancy. Okay, so all these can lead to gas under the diaphragm. Is there any other finding in the peritoneum? They can ask us whether there is any other finding in the peritoneum. So sometimes you can also see a presence of ground glass appearance of the peritoneum. That is presence of fluid level in the peritoneum. Even that can be seen sometimes. Presence of fluid level in the peritoneum. That can be seen sometimes, okay? And then what are we going to see? So other finding is fluid level. In peritoneum. This is called as ground glass appearance. Ground glass appearance. Next, how are you going to manage the perforated duodenal ulcer? So for perforated duodenal ulcer, we do Rose Graham's operation. So you'll have to tell about the treatment for perforated duodenal ulcer. What do you do if there is perforated gastric ulcer? And then what are the conditions of the patient? See, if there is a perforation, the person will be in acute stage. He will have hypovolemic shock or septic shock. Okay, so they can also ask us about anything about the perforations of duodenal ulcer or gastric ulcer. So these are the different things which they can ask in this x-ray, which is showing the multiple air fluid levels. So this is an x-ray which is showing multiple air fluid levels. So thank you guys for watching my lecture. Thank you.